Mr. Merriman said everything I was going to say. Thank you, Mr. Merriman. You know, all that stuff about good kids and good parents and involved and things like this. It's no secret that this helps to build good adults. I also, of course, want to express my appreciation to Indian Springs. And although we are not there at the moment, I want to express my appreciation to the Unitarian Universalist Church of Birmingham. It's a wonderful place for us. In fact, it's just perfect for us. And you should know that that church also donates, just as Indian Springs does, donates that space for our use. And we're extremely grateful. And we want you to know about the support that we have out there in the community and how deeply appreciative we are. We have one more piece of that for you. I will remind you that there is reception, so please join us. With young children who may be with us, and we're delighted to have young children in our audience, please be aware that there's a big art show, as you may have already seen, hung in the halls and in the lobby area of the building that is on the artwork done by Indian Springs School students. So particularly if you have young ones with you, come and enjoy the reception, certainly, but try to keep an eye on them so, you know, no cupcake winds up on somebody's beautiful artwork. So we do ask you to do that, and right now we have one final piece to play for you. It's an arrangement for strings of a concerto originally written by Antonio Vivaldi for two trumpets. You know, every year we have a competition amongst our favorite students to play a solo with the Alabama Youth Symphony on our showcase concert in March. And as of yesterday, we do know which student had been selected as a winner of that audition. So I'm proud to announce that the soloist on showcase representing Birmingham Prelude Strings this year will be Anna Ayers. Anna's